Hello, good morning. Welcome to the online class. So in our previous lesson, we have discussed about the introduction to the programming in Java, introduction of the programming, components of the programming, these two topics we had discussed. Today we will be discussing about the operators in Java. Okay. So operators are the symbols that are used to carry out the specific operations. For example, plus operator is used to carry out the addition, multiplication, that star, asterisk operators is used for multiplication and so on. So in Java, these operators are the tools which help us to do some mathematical calculations and other logical calculations, and also we can do the comparison with the help of the operators. It is a tool which help us to join the variable. There are different types of operators. Three types of operators are there in Java. They are, number one, arithmetic operator. Arithmetic operator, relational operators, and logical . So here in Java we deal with the three types of operators. Okay, so what is arithmetic operator? So we all are familiar with the arithmetic operators. Arithmetic operators are used to perform the arithmetic function. So the operators, we know addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. These are the common arithmetic operators. So it helps us to do the arithmetic operations like addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, and also it gives you the remainder also. So different operators are there. The operator symbols. So, but here there is some difference while writing the symbols. So when I use these operators, so addition, to add, I use the plus sign, same as we do. Subtraction also, we use the minus sign. Multiplication, we use the asterisk sign. Division, and one another for remainder. Remainder is also there. So for remainder and multiplication, we use the slash and modulus operators. So division, we use the forward slash, this slash, and for getting the remainder, we use these operators. So these are the different types of arithmetic operator. Plus operator, symbol, first addition, subtraction, minus operator, multiplication, asterisk, division, this one, and to get the remainder, we use this modulus operator. So these are different types of operators and their symbol. Now each operator needs the two value. It needs two values. So we need to work on the variables. So we need to have, suppose if I have to add, I need to have two numbers. So let number one and number two is there. So I need two values in order to use the operator. So if I have to do n1 plus n2, I can add. So two values are needed in order to use the operators, and these two values are called operands. What is this called? Operands. These are called operands. The values which are used with any of the arithmetic operators or any of the other operators are called operands. OPERANDS, operands. The operands can be of numeric or fractional data type. So we'll be going to the data type also. So what is the data type? We'll do that. So you just have to understand that Java consists of three types of operators: arithmetic, relational, and logical operators. Arithmetic and logical operators, and in arithmetic operators we have add, symbol plus, subtraction symbol minus, multiplication this one, division this one, remainder this one, and these two values, the values which are used with the operators are called operand. This much you should know. So just see one example. So operand 1, operand 2, assignment operator. So if I have to get the result, so if I have to add 20 plus 10 plus 20, how much it will get? I'll get 30. So this is called operand. This is the operand. This is the operator. This is the operator. And this is the result. Now this is also called the operator. This is called assignment operator. So this equals to is called assignment operators. So one expression is made up of operators and assignment operators and operands. So this is how you have to do. Now the second type of operators are called the relational operators. Relational operators are used for determining the relationship between the operand. So you have understood about the operand, the values which is used by the operators are called operand. So this relation operator determines the relationship between. The relationship between the operands lie equality, whether that two values are equal or not, whether one is greater than other, whether another is smaller or bigger, can be determined by comparing the two operand. Operand, I have understood the two values which are there. The comparison may result either true or false value. So when we compare that, what will be the result? The result may be true or false. Is A greater than B? So if A is greater, then it said yes, otherwise it said no. Only these operators you say yes or no, true or false. So the different types of relational operators and the symbols are, the different types of operators are, relational operators are the different types of relational operators are, number one, greater than. Second type, greater than equals to. Third type, less than. Fourth type, less than equals to. Fifth one, equals to. Sixth one, not equals to. Not equals to. So these are six types of relational operators. These are the six types of relational operators. Six types of relational operators are there. Greater than equals to, less than equals to, and not equals to. Now you know the symbol, we use greater than symbol. This is the greater than symbol. Greater than equals to, so we use greater than and we'll put equal sign. Less than equals to, less than is the less than sign. Less than equals to, so less than equals to also we just have to put the less than sign, then we have to put the equals to sign. Now you just see the equals to sign. So equals to sign, we generally use the single equal sign. So here in Java, in operators, it is taught that it is this. If you have to use the two equals to sign in order to equate the value, make whether they, to check whether these two are equal or not. So here you need to remember that equals to sign, we need to use two equals. So if you use only one equals to sign, that it is it's an assignment. This is an assignment operator. Okay, assignment operator. Now not equals to, what you have to do in not equals to, you just have to put the exclamation mark, then equals to. So this is not equals to. So these are the relational operators and their symbol. Operators greater than, greater than, greater than equals to, greater than equal, less than, less than, less than equals to, less than equals to, equals to, equals to, not equals to. So these are the symbols. So this, when we use these operators with the operand, relational operators with the operand, we can get either true or we can get the false value. Okay, either true or false. Now let us come to the third types of operators in Java. The third type of operator is the logical operators. Logic means the composition, whether it's a logic means to say based on some condition, isn't it? So logical operators are used to logically join the two or more relational operators. So logical operators is used as a connectors between the two relational operators. So let us discuss about the logical operators. The operators are used to logically join the two or more relational operations. These are also called conditional operators, and they add condition on the relational operation being used. The use of logical operators returns the value as true or false. Here also logical operators also returns the value either true or false. In the single logical expression, only one logical operators can be used. So you should remember that only one logical expression can be used at a time. So the different types of logical operators are, let us discuss the different types of logical operators. So we have discussed about the arithmetic operators, we have discussed about the relational operators. Now we are discussing about the logical operators. So logical operator one is logical AND operator. Logical AND. So we have to write in capital letter. Let me write in capital letter. Logical AND operator. So AND is one type of logical operator. Logical OR operator. And the third one, logical NOT. Logical NOT. These are the three types of operator: logical AND, logical OR, and logical NOT. So logical AND, what is the symbol of logical AND? We have to give two AND symbol. We have to give two AND symbol for logical AND. Logical OR, we have to use two pipes. This is the symbol for logical OR. And logical NOT, so we use NOT equals to, so one exclamation mark. So this is the symbol of logical AND, logical OR, and logical NOT. Now let us see where this AND is used. This logical AND returns true only if both the conditions are true. If the relations are true, then it will give you the true values. In other conditions, it returns the false value. If returns true only if both the relations are true and false if all the other conditions return false. So it returns, if both the things are correct, then it will give you the true, otherwise it will give the false. Two conditions are there. If both the conditions are satisfied, then it will give you the true value, otherwise it will not give you the true value. Next, the OR operators returns false only if both the relations are false. In all other conditions, returns the true. If both the relations are false, then it gives false. Otherwise, it gives you the It will the both relations are false. Return false only if both the relations are false. Not operators returns true if relation is false. If the relations are false, then it will give you the true value. Sorry, it will give you the false. The logical operator can be applied on the relation in the following way. Say 5 equals to 4, comma 9 equals to 9 are two relations. Suppose these are the two relations. 5 equals to 5, 9 equals to 9. These are the two relations. Now, in the first case, if I use AND operator, if I use if it's this first case, what will be the output? If it's this case, what will be the output? And if it this case, 5 bracket, not equals to 4. In this case, what will be the output? If this AND is used, then it will give you the false. This will give you false. This will give you, this will also give you true, and this will also give you true because it is not equals to. So this is the relation. That is, if 5 equals to 4 and 9 equals to 9 are two relations, then 5 equals to 4 and 9 equals to 9 results in false, as the first relation is false because 5 is not equals to 4. And if another condition is there, either or operator is used here, it gives you the true condition because any one needs to be correct. And in the third one, it's given that not equal. So then it's true because as the relation is false. So these are some of the operators which are used in Java. Generally, there are three types of operators. Now let us discuss about the assignment operators. We have discussed the assignment operator that time also. Now let us detail the assignment operators in this detail. So these are the three types of operators. Now we will be discussing about another type of operators called assignment operators, which are used to assign the variables and the values to the assigned values and constants to the variables. Okay, now let us see assignment operator. Assignment operators. So let us discuss this. An assignment operators is used to store the values on the right of the operators into the variables on the left side of the operators. The assignment operators used in Java is single equals to sign. This is the assignment operator, equals to sign. So for example, if I write integer a equals to 10. That means I am assigning the value 10 to A. That means A is holding 10. That means it is holding the 10. So assignment operators are used to assign the values, and that values can be stored. Here, the literal value 10 on the right hand side of the operator is assigned to the variable A declared as an integer on the left side of the operator. Similarly, if I give another equation like x equals to y plus z. Now this is the assignment operators here. Whatever result will be there, that will be kept in x. Whatever result will come, that can be stored in the x. The equals to operators is different from Java equals to operators. The former is used to assign the operators to store the values, and later is used as the equality comparison operators to check if the right hand side is equals to the left hand side of an expressions and are equals or not. In some programming codes, the value of the variable needs to be increased and decreased by a constant, and each expression used in Java for this purpose are can be written as plus equals to 6. X equals to plus equals to 6. That means it is x equals to x plus 6. So we can write in a short form also x equals to x plus 6. X plus equals to 6 means x equals to x plus 6. Similarly, we can use operators minus equals to 6. So we can write it as x equals to x minus 6. So we can use the operators equals to assignment operators and arithmetic operator together and in a short form also. So the last type of the last thing which we will discuss today is the data types. Datas are raw facts or figures. Many types of datas are used during the programming, such as integer data, real data, character data, string data, and boolean data. The data types tells the compiler about the kind of data it can be used by the programmer. So data types are a way to handle the different types of data. Data types are needed to identify the types of data of an object, to restrict the values that the object can store, to define the meaning of the data, to define the operation associated with the data, and so on. The data types are of four types, categorized as numeric data type, fractional data type, character data type, and boolean data type. So we have just introduced the chapter data type today. So in next class we will be discussing this further, and we will also learn how to declare the and initialize the variables using the data type. Thank you.